Good morning, everyone. If you're able, would you please stand and we'll sing our opening hymn and our bulletin we have coming to us.
In his name. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. You know what, friends? One day you're going to close your eyes in death. People's going to look back over your life, and they're going to remember you for something. Your story, your life, is either going to be one that has brought honor and praise unto God, or one that hasn't. I wanted people to know that this is my story. My song, not your story, not your song. Praising my Savior, not just on Sundays, not just on Wednesdays, but all the day long, every day. You know, we can worship. We come together on Sundays and Wednesdays here at Victory for corporate worship. And I'm glad that we can do that. It's good to see your smiling faces. And pray one with another. And worship together as children of the Most High God.
Amen.
But you know, there's times that you can have individual worship.
That's right.
And you know, if you're just waiting on corporate worship, then you're missing out on many wonderful blessings in your life. Because you can have individual worship as well. We welcome you this morning to the Lord's house. If you're visiting, we're glad you're here. I'm glad that some of you are here with your mothers. And I know some of our folks are probably away with their mothers. But, you know, happy Mother's Day to all mothers. I want you to know that. We recognize you. We appreciate you. But we're not here to worship you this morning. We're here to worship God. I hope you understand that. He and He alone is the only one that's worthy of our worship. A few announcements that I do need to make. Don't forget the Tuesday morning Bible study at 10 o'clock. Come be with us if you can. Wednesday night. Choir practice at 6:30, adult Bible study here in the sanctuary at 7, children and teens Bible study and activities down in the Christian Life Center at 7 o'clock. Then don't forget this Saturday, 10 o'clock, the women's Bible study. Sister Donna will be teaching it. You pray for her, be teaching on the armor of God. You come be a part of that, supporter if you can. Also, we will have a gospel singing and a covered dish meal. Some people call it potluck, so I hope you understand. Bring something. Bring a lot. We like to eat good, can't you tell? But that starts at 5 o'clock on Saturday, June the 8th. Pray about that. Also, Vacation Bible School, June 23rd through the 28th. Don't forget that. And also coming up here in a couple of Wednesdays, on May the 29th, that's our joint church get-together. It will be at Welcome Baptist Church over here in the Bannertown community. I'll give you directions. It's not far from here. And Lord willing, Brother Chris will be preaching that night. So you remember that service coming up on May the 29th. Also, May 26th, it's a Sunday. I'd like to recognize our high school graduates. High school graduates. So if you are a high school graduate this year, please let me know before then. I know that's only a couple of weeks away. But you remember that. We're going to recognize our high school graduates during our worship service at 11 o'clock that morning. And with that being said, I have a card here. The senior class of East Surrey High School announces its commencement exercises Friday evening, June 7th, 2019 at 7 o'clock at East Surrey High School. In case of inclement weather, the ceremony will be held in the gymnasium. And this is for Nathaniel Evan Sheets, otherwise known as Double Naught. So you remember that. And it says also right here, got a little note, says, celebrate with Nathan on Graduate Sunday, May the 26th, at Victory Baptist Church, Mount Airy, during the 11 o'clock worship service. Lunch will be served afterwards in the Christian Life Center. And it's got RSVP to Renee. So if you're going to stay for lunch, and I trust you all will, hey, free lunch. You ain't got to bring nothing, and I can preach long. But you let her know. They need a number so they can prepare the food, okay? So please let her know, and don't let her know that morning, okay? They need to know ahead of time so they can prepare food. I trust that you will all come out for that. Also, I have another note here. It says, Happy Mother's Day to all of our wonderful mothers. The WMU will be giving gifts to all mothers after the worship service. As you go out the vestibule, the WMU has something for you mothers. And also, the WMU will be meeting tomorrow at 11 o'clock here at the church. And all ladies are invited to that tomorrow here at the church. All right. Are there any more announcements? If not, our prayer time, those that we mentioned during our 9:30 time this morning, on the back of the bulletin, do remember these, and then some more immediate concerns. Certainly the lost, they're at the top of the list. My prayer is, if you're here today and you're lost, today is a good day for you to get saved. I want you to know that. Remember Buck Lankford, Christy Holifield, J.D. and Marla, Rabin's daughter, Cheryl Bennett. Remember her. She had to have surgery, had to have a toe removed. Denny Sizemore, that's Peggy's father. Remember him. Sharon Thomas, continue to lift her up. Charles Vernon, Connie Hensley, Clara Barrier, that's Phyllis's sister, had surgery this week. Jimmy and Evie Riggs, I mentioned Sister Donna with the Women's Bible Study, continue to remember her. Rita Martin, that's Chris's mom, not feeling well today. He asked for prayer for her, so you remember Miss Rita. Marie Key, Cody and Ashley Flippin, in that situation there as they're trying to help these children, so you continue to remember them as you pray. Samantha Kovac, Marsha Frazier, Don Thor is scheduled right about this time to have that pacemaker put in. You remember him. Early Gilly. And then our vacation Bible school is right around the corner. And then our gospel singing on Saturday, June the 8th. I'd ask that you remember all of these. Any others you want to mention at this time before we pray? Anywhere? If not, Brother Johnny Lankford, would you lead us to the Lord in prayer at this time, please, brother? Yes, God, yes.
I pray in one accord, Father, seeking your will and your way. Look at you, Father. The Holy Spirit take over this morning.
Yes, God.
God, Brother Joy, in the message that he has.
Help us, Father.
To fill all knowledge, Father. Just fill us full of the Spirit, Father. We can take it out and go through the communities, Father, this week and share it with other people, Lord. That may draw more to your house. May call some lost souls to be saved. Pray, Father, for all the sick and afflicted, Father, that we see this morning. You know who they all are. You know their problems, Lord. I pray you would look on them all with mercy. Reach down with a merciful hand here. Lift them up, Lord, and make them well. It's your will. Bless all those, Father, that have lost a loved one, Father. I pray that they would be with them in their time of need. Just give them a peace, Father, they can hold them from you. Pray just be with us the rest of the service today, Lord. Bless us all, for it's all in Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Johnny. Appreciate the good, humble prayer.
George,
yes?
My sister's having surgery in the morning. She's got a cyst in a bad area and it's flared up 3 times this month. Just remember
Sister Scarlett's sister, Sue, tomorrow as she has surgery. Remember this request. If you're able, please stand and turn with us and turn in your red hymn book to page 235. We'll sing all 3 verses of He Set Me Free, 235.
Once I'm a burden, prison, I fled the freedom from my sorrow.
come forward and receive the morning tithes at this time. I'm glad Jesus set me free.
Amen.
Free. Free. Not bound by anything this morning. Not bound by religion. I'm not free to sin. I am free from sin. I'm no longer my own. And if you're a child of God, you're no longer your own. You've been bought by a price from one that made us free. Hallelujah. Brother Tim Flippin, ask the blessing on the tithes and offerings, please.
Heavenly Father, it's
yes, it is, God. Yes, God. Yes, thank you, Father.
We just hope for us to get out of the way and let you move through, Heavenly Father, in the mighty name. Heavenly Father, go with us. Lead God, direct us along this whole life journey. Heavenly Father, may we always look to you in all things.
Yes.
Ask all this in the precious Son of Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Fellowship one with another. If you'd like to sing, make your way right on up here.
Yeah.
If you will, turn with me in your Bible this morning for a little while to the book of Matthew, chapter number 23. Matthew chapter 23. I'm going to read you a few verses there at the end of this chapter. I know with it being Mother's Day, and I know that Proverbs 31 will probably be preached in numerous places today about a virtuous woman, and I'm glad that we'll preach that King Lemuel wrote down. And I know there's many places that we could go, and we could talk about mothers. I mean, we could talk about Mother Earth. We could talk about Eve, the mother of all living. We could talk about Mary, the mother of Jesus. We could talk about Elizabeth, the mother of John the Baptist. We could talk about Eunice and Lois, the mother and grandmother of Timothy, and what they've left. But the Lord placed this passage of Scripture upon my heart a while back this week, and gave me some thoughts, and I'll try to share it with you. Maybe it won't take too long today. I know some of you is wanting to go and have lunch with your mothers, and some of your mothers may not understand us staying here just a little bit longer. I don't know. But I can tell you this, we need to be at God's table first. Amen. First and foremost, we need to get what God would have us to have. So if you have your place in the Word of God, Matthew chapter 23, I'm going to begin reading in verse number 37. This is written in red in my Bible. So this is our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, His words that is spoken here. And the Bible says, O Jerusalem, Jerusalem. Can you see the lament in his voice? Oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem. It's like he's astonished at him. Thou that killest the prophets and stonest them which are sent unto thee, how often would I have gathered thy children together, even as a hen gathereth her chickens under her wings, and you would, here's the critical word, not. There's a difference between would and would not. And because of that, listen in verse number 38. It's God's outline. Behold, your house is left unto you desolate. For I say unto you, ye shall not see me henceforth till ye shall say, blessed is he that cometh in the name of God. Of the Lord. May God bless this portion of His precious and His holy word. Now I realize this is taking place right here close to the time when Jesus is getting ready to go to the cross, and He's getting ready to offer His life there for our sins on that old Roman cross. And I believe if I've studied my Bible correctly, this is the very last words that He ever spoke in the temple in Jerusalem before He left this world. Oh, how sad. He left them a pronouncement of judgment because they would not gather themselves unto Him like they were supposed to. I want you to know today, friends, I see the same thing happening in America. He starts out here in verse 37 and says, Oh, Jerusalem. Oh, Jerusalem, what a lamentable voice, a sad, a sorrowing voice, a voice of astonishment. And I can't help but wonder if Jesus himself today is still having that kind of voice when he looks down upon what we call God bless America as he sees the things that are happening all around us. Now, I'm glad right here he tells them why. Does he not? You've killed and you've stoned those that I have sent unto you, that I have warned, that I have sent to warn you about the judgment that is to come. And the ones that have called, repent and come to God, repent and come to God, repent and come to God. If you would have just listened to them, if you would have just done what I told you to do, he said, I would have gathered you under my wings like a mother hen would to her little chicks. Now, you know, I like that. You know, the great thing about Jesus is he knew how to put it right where they lived every day. I mean, they was chickens and roosters and hens and everything running around over there, and goats and sheep and donkeys and all that stuff. You know what? He gave them a real life illustration there, Marty, that they could see exactly what would happen. Now, I don't know a whole lot about chickens. We grew tobacco. We didn't do much with it. But I can tell you one thing. When I was a younger fella, my grandfather had chickens and roosters. He had a pet rooster named Luke. And this pet rooster would follow him. And you know, when he poured out them chunks of dry dog food in the bowl, that rooster wanted one. He'd feed that rooster. And that rooster followed him like a dog. But I'm going to tell you something. He had some hens running around there too. You know what? They never did mess with you. Now that old rooster, he might flog you if you got in his way, spur you. But he was pretty much a pet. He was tame, but he ruled the roost around there. But there's something I want to tell you. I remember one time one of them hens had a little bunch of witties. We call them biddies, witties. Little baby chickens. They'd hatched. Now let me tell you something. First of all, you didn't move her off that nest before they's hatched. She'd lay into you. Hello, America. We got them aborting babies left and right. We don't have mothers that care for them like the animals do. That's a message that needs to be preached. But listen, you would not move her off that nest. You better not. I wouldn't have gone to anyway. At times, Grandpa might reach under there and get some eggs, and he'd take a peck or two, but not this boy. I was afraid of that mother. But when he let her nest and she was going to have some babies, that's what he wanted. Them things finally hatched. Brother Johnny, they was running through the yard down there one time. And me and some of the other youngins there in the neighborhood, we decided we was going to play and try to run. You know, everybody wants one of them little baby chicks, don't they? I mean, if you don't believe me, go over to Tractor Supply or some of these places around Easter. And they got them out there. They just are selling them left and right for people. And I thought I was going to go through there and get me one of them. Wrong. Let me tell you, this little old hen about this size, she run this boy. Hey, let me tell you, she ran and she ran and she had them wings and I was afraid of her. What about one of them geese? I never have figured out if they call plural of a moose, if a goose is a geese, why ain't a moose a meese? Well, you figure that out another time. But anyway, a mother goose, when she has her baby geese, she would fight a lion. Yeah. You ever been around them? She'll raise them wings. She'll hiss. She'll lay into you. And I'm big enough. I'm a whole lot bigger than that goose. But you know what? I'm going to let her have her space. I ain't going to mess with her. Jesus is telling them right here, if you would have just listened to me, I know what you've done. You've killed the prophets. You've stoned them. But if you'd repent of your sins and get your heart right, he said, I would have called you unto me, and I would have protected you. I noticed something else about that hen. When the old dog or the cat started coming around, that little hen would let out a cluck. And don't think I'm going to try to make that sound. But if you've never heard it, go check it out. She had a distinct sound, and it wasn't too loud. I ought to try it, but I'm not going to. She'd do a little cluck. And you know what, Brother Luke? When she'd do that, here come them little witties. They'd come right to her. If they was over here, over yonder, they'd just come like a whirlwind right to her. And she'd just spread them wings out, and she'd just sort of sit down. And you couldn't see a one of them. You didn't know a single one of them was there, but they was all there. You know where they was at? They was under the safety of their mother's wings. And it was a good warm place, and it was a comfortable place when they was near where their mother was at. I want to say it to you today as a church, that if you're out of the will of God, if you're walking afar off and you're not where you ought to be, he's still clucking. He's still bidding you to come right now. He's a God of mercy. He's a God of grace. His judgment has not been cast out yet. He's still seeking to save those that were lost. If you'll just come, honey, you'll get safety. You'll get comfort under the big old wings of Jesus. And I'll tell you, even though that mother hen had a distinct voice and a distinct cluck, my God has a distinct voice too. And he has a distinct way of speaking. And if you're here today and your heart's a-pounding and you're wondering what's speaking to you, I'll tell you who it is. It's God through the Holy Spirit. And he's telling you right now, if you'll just come, he'll give you safety. He'll give you protection. I'm glad that when the storms of life come, he's a storm protector. I'm glad he's the best storm shelter you never have. I'm glad when the sickness comes, he's still the great physician. I'm glad when your soul is sorrowful and you don't know what to do, he's still a burden bearer. He'll still pick you up. He'll take the tears of sorrow and turn them into shouts of joy. But you got to be willing to come to his voice and get under his wings. Now there's some things here today that I want to share with you about a mother, a mother's love, and God's love. And there is many similarities.
Right.
to this. And time would not allow me to preach them all today. But I can preach on some of them that I think that you can relate to and that you can understand this morning. The first thing that I want to think about, as God was showing me this, a mother is the one that gives birth to her children. You ever seen any daddies give birth? No, they too weak and wimpy anyway, ain't they, women? They get a little cold, they about done. Women be sick to death and still get up and clean and cook and iron and look after things for the man. Why? Yeah, I'm telling it like it is. The woman gives birth unto that child. There is a special bond that a man can have with her child. That mother carries that child in her womb for those 9 months. I mean, that's as close can get, folks. And then at the time of birth, she almost dies, and some do, giving birth. To bring that child into this world. And let me tell you something. You shall not get that child ever out of that mother's arms or that mother's heart.
Amen.
I don't care what they do, how far they go. They will always receive an unconditional love of their mama. And that's something us men don't understand sometimes. But now I'm going to give you a twist on this. You see, since God the Father doesn't have a wife, He gives us a new birth. A new birth. And listen to this. As we talk about the lady, those 9 months as she carries the child in the womb, God puts up with our sin, if you will. That might not be a good word of putting it. But let me say, His mercy deals with us through our sinful times. And maybe He calls many a time, come be saved, come be saved, come be saved. And time after time, people reject. But guess what? I like His part. When somebody gets birthed into the family of God, and God gives them that new birth, no one will ever pluck that child of God out of His hand. Because He has unconditional love. Oh yeah, there's times we wander and there's times we do wrong and He has to whoop us. Did your mom ever whoop you when you done wrong? Mine did. Boy, she'd take that leather belt and ring your bell with it. She'd get your attention. They say, don't do that today, preacher. That's child. That's what do they call it? Child abuse.
Yeah.
Well, all right. Keep trying it your way.
Yeah.
Look at how America's going today.
Amen.
Hello. Let me just tell you something. There was a lady working in a restaurant over here. She's a manager. I heard the other day she'd hired a little girl. Helped part-time around the restaurant. You know what the first thing she told her? She said, take the broom and the dustpan, go out there and sweep in the lobby. You know what that little youngin' did? I guess had to be 16 years old to get a job. Said, what's that?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what's wrong with the world today.
Amen.
We're raising a bunch that think they got to have everything. You need to teach them how to sweep.
Amen.
You need to teach them how to fold their clothes and put it in their drawers. Because if not, one day they're going to get out on their own and they ain't going to know nothing.
That's right. Amen.
A real mother loves and teaches and rears them up to be able to go forward in life and get married and have children of their own if God allows. And you know what? He does the same thing for us as Christians. When we are born into the family of God, that's not it. He never intended for us to stay a newborn. He intended for us to grow. He intended for us to learn some things. He gave us some chores. He gave us some duties so that we can come up and be the mature people of God that He wants us to be.
Amen,
amen, preacher. Something else I find about a mother. She'll hold that baby when it can't walk. I remember when Ashley was born, one of the first things the nurse did, took Ashley and put her, not in my arms. Know where she put her? Heidi's arms.
Yeah.
And you know what? Heidi kept her in her arms.
Yeah.
As long as she could.
Amen.
But there did come a time She learned how to walk. But until then, Heidi cradled Ashley. Wherever Heidi walked, Ashley was in her arms. Now, I know I helped in that some, but not like Heidi. You mothers know what I'm talking about. I was afraid I'd drop her. I mean, this was my firstborn, Tim. I mean, really, I wasn't sure about this. But I was assured I wouldn't. But Heidi did most of it. And wherever Heidi went, Luke, that young'un was in her arms. And I say it to you today, and I'm not bragging, but I'm just telling you like it is. We took it serious when God blessed our home with our children. And they were no longer a burden or an obligation. But they were a part of us, and we loved them, and we still love them, and we love them both the same and unconditionally. And you know what, Brother Chris? No matter what, they're ours. And I'm going to tell you something. And I'm not preaching to you. You just happen to be here while I'm a preacher. I'm going to tell you something. All through the journey of life, wherever we went, they went. Hello? If we went on a vacation, they went on vacation. Brother David, if we went out to eat, they went out to eat. If we went somewhere, they went somewhere. And we didn't pawn them off on Grandpa and Grandma and say, you look after them this weekend because we got to go party and play. Hello, that's the problem in the world today. When God blessed our home with these young'uns, Brother Tanner, they were a part of us, and we loved them, and we still love them, and we would give anything we could give, anything that we've got to make sure that they've got the best life they can have. But I'm thankful unto God. I've got a God. I've got a Savior that has promised He'd never leave me. He'd never forsake me. He would go with me all the way, even to the end of the world. He's promised that He'd be a father to the fatherless. He'd be a wife to the widow, or a mother to the motherless. I promise you, whatever you need, God is it. And He will never, ever take His love away from you. Amen. Something else I find. That mother closes. We didn't know how to pick out our clothes. What was the first thing? As she got ready to come home from hospital, old Heidi dolled her up in one of them pretty little doll outfits. Ashley don't know nothing about it. Ashley didn't know how to put her clothes on. Neither did Brock. But there was a mama that knowed how to clothe her. And listen, this mama loved her so much. I'm going to have me a fit here in a minute. This mama loved her so much. She's going to put on the best, nicest outfit we could get. It may have been given to us as a shower gift. I don't know. But I tell you one thing, it was a pretty outfit. I want to say unto you, my God has never clothed me with no junk. My God has always clothed me with the best that He's got. You say, what did He clothe you with? He clothed me with the robes of His righteousness. He clothed me with fine linen, white and clean. Because when He looks at me now, He no longer sees a sinner. He no longer sees nobody nasty. He says, that's my child now. They've been birthed into the family of God. And I'm proud of my young'un that's in my family. You say, this is supposed to be a Mother's Day message. It is, but I want to tell you something. God's love's greater than a mother's. Amen. I've had people say a mother's love is just as good as God's. No. You hang on, I'll explain it before I get up. You'll know the difference here in a minute. Something else I find about a mother. Feeds us. Who feeds you today, spiritually speaking? God. Amen. Sometimes you say, well, a lot of times you don't want to eat spiritually. You know why? You're full of the world.
That's right. Amen.
You're full of the junk food of the world. But God wants to feed you spiritually. He's not going to feed you the junk food of the world. You know what? The more you dig and the more you want to eat and the hungrier you get, the thirstier you get, the more He'll feed you, the more He'll thrill you, the more He'll fill you. He's water for a dry, thirsty soul. He's food for a hungering soul. Yeah. I'll tell you something else about Him. And there's times in our life when we have to be cleaned up.
Yeah.
Oh, some of them stinky diapers. I remember them. But you know what? Mama wasn't going to let that young'un stay in that stinky diaper. Just this year. Hey, let me tell you something. Every now and then, I don't know if y'all remember this, and I'm just blunt and plain anyway. The internet may not understand it, but you folks here in Mount Airy do. There'd be times that she just wasn't sure. She'd poke that diaper open and take a look. Making sure there wasn't a mess there. Why? Because she didn't want her young'un in that mess.
Right. Yeah.
And if there happened to be a mess there, she's going to clean that up.
Amen.
God help these parents let these young'uns wallow around in their field. She'd make sure that she had, I mean, when we went somewhere, we had diaper bags. I mean, we had enough diapers. We might not be gone but for 3 hours, but we had enough diapers for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And I told them around, why? You never know what might happen. But I want you to know something today, that there's times in our Christian life we get nasty.
Amen.
We get dirty. Hey, listen, as these babies, they didn't know no better. They just knowed it was time to potty, and they pottied right there. They had to be potty trained, didn't they?
Yeah.
Well, listen, there's times in our Christian life we get a little nasty. And we get a little bit dirty. Now, listen, there was times when we had them almost potty trained. They know to go to potty, and yet they'd make a boo-boo in their britches. I'm just an old plain preacher. There's days today that God's people, His children, know to stay out of the world. And to not get theirself dirty with the things of the world, and yet we still do it sometimes. And we know better, but guess what? He won't leave us in our filth, Brother Caleb. He'll still clean us up.
Amen.
And I want you to know today, I'm telling you about a God that is greater than any mother. And I tell you something else. During sickness, there was times as a young'un when I got sick at home, you know who I called out for? In the middle of the night, I didn't say, Daddy. I said, Mama. Mama. You see, Mama could fix it. And if Mama couldn't fix it, if Mama just put her arms around me, I knowed I was in good hands. But I want you to know as a Christian today, when you get yourself in a mess and you get yourself in a trouble, it's time to do like the Apostle Paul says. We need to call out, Abba! Daddy! I need you, Daddy! Because your arms can wrap around me and everything will be all
right.
We need to realize that. Something else I find, and I've already touched on it, a mama loves unconditionally. Hey, listen, I don't care how far your young'uns go. You might get mad at them. You might get upset. Sometimes you might want to just wring her neck. I mean, I'm being honest. Sometimes they get you so mad and so tore up you can't stand it.
Yeah.
They know better. We taught them better. Now, what in the world are they doing? But you know what? That unconditional love says, I'll not cast you off.
Yeah.
God's unconditional love says He will not cast us off.
Amen.
You know He gets fretted with us sometimes. You know He gets upset sometimes how we're living. But you know what? He still loves us.
Amen.
And He wants to get us straightened out. Finally, last point. I told you it wouldn't be too long today. Watches over us. Just as that mother hen, Jesus said, Oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you that have stoned and have killed the prophets.
Yeah.
How often? Often means more than once.
Yeah. Amen.
How often I would have gathered you under my wings. Like a chicken does its little chickens,
Amen.
The little babies. You know, He watches over us. There's times you and I don't realize that there is an imminent danger right in front of us. And God protects us from some harm. Why? Because where He is.
Yeah.
We know the sound of His voice, that cluck. And from all places we come running under His wings. And do you know what? There's not too many animals that would dare attack a mother hen. But I'm going to tell you something today, and I'm shutting her down. Lori, come on. That if that were to happen, that mother hen would give her life for those little witties. She would not run off. She would fight till her last dying breath to protect them. Now here, my friends, is where I want you to see the much greater love of God than a mother's love. Because you see, my God gave His only, only, not one of them, but only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. He offered Him freely on a cross, the beating that He took, the shame that He faced. I'm talking about God's only begotten Son. You mothers, think about if you've got a child, would you give your child for a stranger? No. Would you even give your child for your husband? You might give yourself for a loved one, but you would not give yourself for a stranger.
Amen.
But you see, one day in my sin, Johnny, I was away from God.
Amen.
I was an alien. I was a stranger. But Marty, almost 2,000 years before I was born,
yeah,
God looked through the windows of eternity,
yeah,
and said, here is a greater love than a mother's love.
Amen.
Here is a greater love than love that the world has ever known.
Amen.
I have given my child,
amen,
freely for the world.
Amen.
That's the greatest love. If you're here today and you're lost without Jesus, let me tell you, today's a great day to get saved.
Amen.
If you want to make your mother's mother day, let me tell you what to do. Give your heart and life to Jesus. I've heard people say, if you want to do something for your mother, sit beside Auburn Church today. I'm glad they are. But let me tell you something, if you're here and you're lost, if you really want to do something for your mother, give your heart and life to Jesus Christ today. Because you know, one day your mama's going to die. One day your mama's going to leave this world. And I tell you what, wouldn't it be wonderful for her to be able to leave this world knowing that her child is saved.
Amen.
There's no greater love than God's love. I'm thankful for all of you mothers. I really am. But I am most thankful for my Lord and Savior.
Amen.
My God. My comforter. Listen, there's times in the night when the child has cried for mama. And mama may come and she'll settle that child. And after a while, she'll lay that child down and go back to her bed. Why? Because she needs rest. There's a greater love with God. You see, when He comes to put His arms in there, He ain't gonna lay you down.
See it.
No, He ain't gonna lay you down. My Bible says in the book of Colossians, my life is hid with Christ in God. That's a great place. In the book of Isaiah, He told the Jewish people, He said, you are engraved in the palm of my hand. You know what that tells me, Christy? He's held those Jewish people so long. You know how your fingerprints got something unique nobody else has got? I believe He's held the Jewish people so long that they are engraved in the palm of His hand. Guess what? We're engraved in the palm of His hand too. And it's in the form of a nail. Let's stand. This invitation is yours. Whatever the need may be, if you're here and you're lost, I invite you to come be saved today. Don't just come be saved for mama. Come be saved for you. You're the one. Your eternity's in the balance. If you're here and you're a mother, you're saying, well, I could improve and be a better mother. There's no better way to do it. Commit your life to God. Just like they sung a while ago, we must submit. If you're going to have joy with the Lord, you've got to submit first. If you're not submitting, you're rebelling. Christian, invitation's yours. Lost person, I ain't going to tell you the invitation. But I give you an invitation to come. Take that step of faith. Come, be saved today. While she plays, if God is dealing, whatever the need may be, it's between you and God. This is your invitation. It's not my invitation. It's your invitation that God has allowed you to have right now. Bible says no greater love is this than a man lay down his life for his friends. When we were lost, we were not the friends of God. We were the enemies of God. That's an even greater love that he would lay down his life for his enemies. I believe the invitation is sufficient. Anybody got a word for the Lord before we go?
Well, Joey, I'd like to thank and wish all the mothers here a happy Mother's Day.
Amen.
Thank you. It's been a tough week. I lost my mom a few years ago. Now you were talking about the greatest love is being saved and mama being going to heaven. But, you know, it comforts me to know that when she was on her deathbed, it's when we finally knew that she was saved, where she was going. You know, it's a blessing to me to know that I'm going, and I'm going to see my mother again.
Amen. And there'll never be another goodbye.
Thank God for making me a mother.
Yeah. Amen.
And for, thank God for my children and for my mother.
Yeah.
And I thank God she knows where I'm going. When the choir was singing earlier, precious beauty, I thought about my mom.
Uh-huh.
She was standing in the kitchen, fixing lunch, and she was singing, you know, hymn.
Yeah.
Precious beauty. Some of the best memories I've got.
That motherly love, you can call it instinct or whatever you want to call it. I call it a gift of God.
Amen.
That is placed in every female is that motherly love. Now, whether or not they carry it out, it's up to them. But I believe that gift is there, given of God. Something us men don't understand. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. A whole lot of us husbands being a fix if it wasn't for our wives.
Right.
Gosh, yeah.
Don't you just describe
how
you're going
to
start.
Amen. Amen. Anyone else?
Thank God for Fred for being here this morning, hearing the precious message he sent to you. I just pray we can all use it this week
with
his
brother. Amen.
Amen.
Be quiet!
Tanner, dismiss us in prayer.
Life, live a better life than you. Just thank you for all.
all the mothers here and what they mean to us all. And thank you for sending your son to die on the cross for us, Lord. And for someone here that does not know you as a personal Lord and Savior, I pray that you would allow them to come to know you before it's eternally too late. Just keep us all safe as we go out of here and go about our lives this week, and keep us safe as we come back the next point in time.
Amen. God bless you. Till we meet again.